Hey guys, welcome back once again. Today I want to share a new format for monthly planning, and you please let me know if this is something you like. I have already shared one before. You can find that video in the description box below.
So around this time of year is a time where a lot of people fall off their goals. They forget about the goals they set at the beginning of the year. We stop setting monthly goals and we just kind of let time fly by and not be intentional about it.
So this plan of the month video is to remind you to set your monthly goals, and it helps you to stay accountable and to stay on track towards making the progress and towards the life you want. Even though we are in a pandemic and the things are really uncertain and crazy,
there are still things that you can do to improve yourself and your life. So we have to focus on what we can control and work on making baby steps. A little bit of progress is better than nothing, right?
Before we start, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to this channel and click the bell if you haven't already. This video is all about me planning for July. You can pause the video and plan with the video. So I have been doing this practice for me personally, but I thought why not share with you all. So if you like this idea, then do let me know in the comment section. And without further delay, let's get started.
Before we actually start a planning process, it is always a good idea to sit back and reflect on the previous month to understand what really went well and what did not. The self-reflection is really the key. It gives us a clear sense of where we were yesterday and where we are today, and help us plan for where we actually want to be. So reflect on the previous month and write down your answers for these prompts. What were your favorite moments this month? It could be as simple as cooking your favorite meal or watching your favorite show or maybe talking to a friend. Just anything made you feel happy and excited. Next, what were you grateful for in the last month? You know, be thankful for all the good things that have happened to you in the last month. Next, what are your small wins in the previous month? You know, cherishing your life wins is always as important as working on big goals. It will keep you motivated and make you feel so good, so don't forget this. Next, what was your one mistake last month and how you plan to avoid it in upcoming months? Guys, realizing your mistakes is as important as cherishing your big wins. So analyze your mistake and see what you could do to make things better. Next, where are you at your big picture goals? So this is something that I do very often to see how far I have progressed through my big goals for this year. So it is always good to check on your big picture goals every month.
So guys, this self-reflection exercise should have definitely given you a clear picture of where you are right now. So let's cheer up and start planning for July. I want to do a wellness challenge in July. So this is a challenge I want to do personally for me, but I'm going to share here in case anybody wants to kickstart their health along with me. So this challenge will include daily meditation, daily exercise, drinking lots of water, no sugar, things like that. So this is just to get mental clarity, strength, more motivation and more energy in life. So when I plan for a new month, I set a theme for that particular month, and my 60 to 70% my goals are focused on that particular aspect, and it will help you to learn new skill, learn new things every single month. And it's been really amazing. Like, I was procrastinating a lot in the learning part, but when I set an intention for the month, it really helps you to try something different or learn new skills.
So July will be creative for me. I have recently changed my editing style in my videos, so I want to work on that more. So after setting up a theme for July, write your 3 to 4 big goals that you really want to achieve this month. Make sure you do not include your habits here, because we tend to write our habits as a goal and we know that we end up not achieving them. So keep your habits separate You can maintain a habit tracker, but write down your big career goals or your big personal goals that you want to achieve this month. I usually write 3 to 4 big goals, and I make sure I include both my personal goals as well as career goals into these big goals. And when you write your big goals, make sure your goals should be very clear. A clear goal is easy to achieve. For example, say your goal is to read more books in July. You know you want to read more books, but what kind of books and within how many days in a week? None of these is clear, right? Rather, your goal is, I want to read 2 non-fiction and 1 fiction books in July. And I will read 1 hour every day before going to bed. Now this sounds more specific because you clearly specified what kind of books you want to read, and it's measurable because you mentioned number of books you want to read. It's attainable because you have a clear action plan, and if you read 1 hour every day, it's highly possible that you can finish 1 book every week, and definitely you can finish 3 books in a month. It's relevant because it helps you in your personal growth journey, and it is time bound as well. So this goal is easy to achieve. Break down monthly goals to weekly goals. So we will create a weekly breakdown for what you want to achieve at the end of each week. At the end of each one, what will that look like? And then at the end of week 2 and week 3 and so on. So this actually helps me know that I am making sure that I actually act on them, and I can track it in a better way. Weekly goals in calendar. So finally, I will take some time to transfer my weekly goals into my calendar, where I can track them throughout the week. It will work like a time block, and time block is really magic. Here, so allocate a specific block of time every single day of work on those tasks that will eventually help me to achieve my goals. It creates consistency and boosts up your morale, and at the end of the month, you are definitely going to get something out of it.
That's all for today. I hope you like this monthly planning video. Do let me know if you want me to create it each month. I think it will be a fun, it will be a reminder for you to create your life, because every month we have a chance to make progress towards the life which we want to create. And I hope you guys stay on track, and if you fall off track, it's okay. Just be gentle, be yourself. Pick yourself back up and try again. Sending you so much of love. Bye.